This is Rebecca from chemistryismygem.com. In this video, we're going to be focusing on electrons and ions, which are atoms with a charge. For electrons, unless you are given a charge, you can assume that the number of protons and the number of electrons match within an atom. This means that you are assuming that the overall charge of the atom is zero. For example, how many protons, neutrons, and electrons are in an atom of helium-4? Well, we learned in the last video that 4 is the mass number. Helium, I can look at the periodic table and I can tell that it has an atomic number of 2. That means that there are 2 protons in this atom. There is not a charge given, so we can assume that the number of protons and the number of electrons match. So there are 2 electrons in this atom. And then from the mass number, we can determine the number of neutrons. Mass number minus protons tells me that there are 2 neutrons in this atom. We can repeat this process for sodium-25. You can look at the periodic table and determine that sodium is element 11, so there are 11 protons. Since we are not given a charge, we can assume that there are also 11 electrons. The 25 is the mass number. Mass number minus protons tells us the number of neutrons. So this isotope of sodium has 14 neutrons. What happens if the number of protons does not match the number of electrons? At that point, you have an atom with a charge, which we call an ion. Comparing the number of protons and electrons helps us to determine whether or not it is a positive or a negative ion. If there are more protons present, then it's positive, and we call it a cation. If there are more electrons present than protons, then it has an overall negative charge, and we call it an anion. So positive ions are called cations, and negative ions are called anions. Here's an example where we will be looking at some ions and determining the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons. Keep in mind that charge is based on the number of protons versus electrons. An ion that has more protons will have a positive charge, and an ion that has more electrons will have a negative charge. The first example is nitrogen-14 with a charge of -3. A quick glance at the periodic table tells me that nitrogen is element 7, so this has 7 protons. To determine the neutrons, I'm going to use this mass number. Neutrons is mass number minus protons, so I'll say 14 minus 7, which gives me 7 neutrons. To determine the number of electrons, I need to use the number of protons and the charge. That charge of -3 tells me that there are 3 more negative particles than there are positive particles. So if I have 7 positive particles, I must have 10 negative particles, or 10 electrons. For those of us who like an algebra formula to figure things out, you can look at the fact that electrons plus charge will always equal protons. In this case, we were trying to determine the number of electrons. We knew that the charge was -3, and the number of protons was 7. So we can solve that, and you will find out that electrons, in this case, was equal to 10. The next example is lithium-7 with a charge of +1. Lithium is element 3 on the periodic table, so there must be 3 protons. The number of neutrons I'm going to get by saying the mass number minus the protons, and 7 minus 3 means that there are 4 neutrons. For the number of electrons, I'm going to compare the charge and the number of protons. The fact that there is a charge of +1 means that there must be 1 more proton than there is electron. So in this case, there's 2 electrons. I could also determine that using the formula. We were trying to find electrons. The charge was a +1, and the number of protons was 3. So when you solve that, you will find out that there are two electrons in this case. The third example is neon 20. This time we're not given the charge, but we are given the number of electrons, so we can still determine everything up here. Neon is element 10 on the periodic table, so there are 10 protons. The number of neutrons I'm going to get by saying 20 minus 10, so there's 10 neutrons. And then I'm going to compare the number of protons to the number of electrons. In this case, they're equal, and when they are equal, that means it's a neutral charge or a zero charge. If you were to put it into the formula, you have 10 electrons, you're trying to find the charge, and you have 10 protons. You'll find out the charge is equal to zero. In the final example, I'm not given the isotope, so I'm going to have to determine that from the protons. Element 34 on the periodic table is selenium. To determine the mass number, I'm going to add together the protons plus the neutrons, and 34 plus 45 is 79. So this is selenium 79. And then to determine the charge, I need to compare the protons and the electrons. There's 34 protons and 36 electrons. You can put that into your formula and calculate the charge, or you can just look at it visually and see that there are two more electrons than there are protons, so this thing is going to have a negative 2 charge. That concludes our discussion of ions. Stick around as we move on to discussing atomic history.